My name is Margaret Ann Windsor, and I was kidnapped from Buckingham Palace in 1941, brought to Moulton, Alabama, and given the name of a twin, Peggy Ann Dempsey. I married a Childers, and my identity was stolen. I was given the name of the dead twin. Both of them, Peggy and Carl, were murdered by their mother. They were born out of wedlock. And I've put all this on former videos for over a year now, since the Alexis Murphy abduction and probably murder. I want to say this right off the bat is why I'm doing this tape again today. And I wrote about mind control murders, which part of it was Larry Flint was shot while I was doing the book in Lawrenceville, Georgia. He was shot and his attorney killed, and he's in a wheelchair as everybody can see, and he even says in the endorsement, he helped me in a political campaign to replace Larry McDonald. He even mentions him here, who I'd written about in the book, medical malpractice book. I'd written about mind control murders, and a lot of cases, some cases at Piedmont Hospital where Larry McDonald worked, murders there. Gene Strokerman was shot down in the office of Hardiman, a psychiatrist. She was suing the psychiatrist. She wasn't suing him, but others, psychiatrists. And I got it by way of my attorney, Eugene Kaiser, who represented me in suits against Victor Gonzalez, who was a psychiatrist. And by the way, he's still practicing psychiatry. And Atlanta and that area, and that it was covered up. There was a gag order put on it. And, if anybody reads this, stop and think about it. Anyway, I wrote about mind control. I had antifreeze put in me April the 1st of 80, and the book never published, and you can't tell the ongoing crimes committed against me. I was carried across the state line. I should have died. And I passed a background check for is required by working for the District Attorney Fred Simpson's office, Madison County, Huntsville. And you get into NASA and all that, my kidnapping. I was brought to Moulton, which is probably, that's past Decatur South, so probably about 50 miles from NASA. And kidnapping, I'm Margaret Ann Windsor, heir to the British Crown. This is my dad. I hope I'm not being redundant. My tapes, for some reason, aren't going up today. My father was forced out, and this whole mess has been a lie that was told on him, the 99-year seal. He never married Wallace Simpson. He was married to Claudia O'Keefe, sister to Georgia, the artist, from Madison, Wisconsin. And Georgia had the ghost ranch, and they tied all of her money up and got it. I wrote about mind control murders. Larry Flint, I guess I am being redundant, was shot in Lawrenceville. I moved to Roanoke and lived on the Appalachian Trail, the forest, national forest. Froze, starved. Every law in the book, I haven't had a civil right. So they're talking about Ferguson, which Missouri, which, by the way, was done in mind control patterns, and that was told to me, the clues, and I'll tell you exactly where, and I hate to get him in trouble, but God knows he's been there along with the rest of them who run me. He's law enforcement. That was July the, I went out there on the 18th, 19th, 21st of 10, and it was North Creek Campground, and where so much has been done to me, too. So I'll leave the Rangers, that's law enforcement's name out. But in essence, he gave me the clues to where I'm at today and in connection to the Ferguson, Missouri. The Wilson is one of the clues, his name, and the Ferguson, and where I'm at. And these can be proven, but this is a psychiatrist finished school at Virginia Tech near me here in Roanoke, and the 33 were, that was mind control. He was under mind control. He's a psychiatrist. You have to wonder why the psychiatrists haven't told the truth in all this. They certainly know. And I'm just going to skip to this and read the letter, and then I'm going to stop it because I'm so sick right at the moment. I'm allergic to chemicals, and they've, in the middle of winter, and it's snowing outside. Well, not the middle of winter, but it's snowing and cold outside here in Virginia, really snowing. This is my son's Mark, this air after me, and Scott, and this is my son's, and this is me, and it's an old photo. And what I'm talking about, I'm just giving you the gist of this. This is, they were done in patterns. NASA is where I was taken near there when I was kidnapped, and this is Mark Kelly, and his brother is Scott Kelly, and they're twins. Remember I said they gave me the name of a twin when they brought me here. And this is Gabby Gifford, who was a congresswoman. I ran and didn't get it when I was flown out to Flint. They're both astronauts and twins, Mark Kelly and Scott Kelly. So I want to go, and my father's was an illegal takedown. Now, they tried to kill me, especially. I was trying to get the book published. Had a letter from the FBI, June the 23rd of 79, and the antifreeze was put in me April Fool's Day of 80, and it's been ongoing like that. It's been a hell, and I haven't had a civil right. And I have to say that law enforcement's been involved in what happened to me, some to the good, some to the bad. But I certainly believe in law enforcement. And this, well, anyway, I wanted to read you Jack Hartsfield. He's a reporter, FBI, and I don't have the other letter with his. He worked at the Huntsville Times when they were trying to kill me from 80 to 82. And he ended up, again, I saw him in 84, March of 84, and he was in Santa Fe, and I was finding out about my kidnapping, my real name, and Georgia O'Keefe, my aunt, lived on Ghost Ranch, just over the mountain in Abiquiu from where Jack was, and he was working for the New Mexican News. I hope I'm not being too redundant. I want to read this, and I've run out of time. I want to read why, in part, that they're not going to tell any of this, and yet these are the people who did it, and obviously in patterns and meant for it to be told. So I'm going to read it here. I put this on other tapes. In moments, I try to make a grounded assessment of all the above. If the dastardly events above, particularly as related to the FBI's Division 5, and they were there in Huntsville, NASA, when I was kidnapped. Well, NASA wasn't there, but Redstone was, when I was kidnapped in 41 and brought near there. And assorted shenanigans were public. What would be the results? It would perhaps be very destabilizing for the nation as a whole. The Huntsville experiments, the agony of 63, that's JFK, who they helped kidnap me, the aftermath, etc. And that was Jack's words. And I was going to say where they, well, I'll just say this. It's where in Huntsville, near where they kidnapped me, or where they took me when they kidnapped me, J. Edgar Hoover's FBI Division 5, a super secret police agency, had operated since the early 40s. So I'm just going to leave it there. I can't read them. I've done it before. But the Ferguson, Missouri is part of that. And it's not just related to that. It's like the Hannah Graham and the murders here at Charlottesville, the University of Virginia, are there and at Blacksburg. And my tape's running out. So, I don't know. The only way to stop it is to tell the truth. And the media is controlled by the Rockefellers, the Freemasons, the Illuminati that kidnapped me. And they control the media. I said that. But the media is a responsibility in all of this. They know the truth. Believe me, they do. Absolutely. None of them are going to tell it. And I sit and watch them attack Policeman Wilson and go after him. Where were they when I was telling all this? They already knew it. And what's happened to me, the pain and suffering and civil rights, I've had none in my sons, my parents, and my country.